if you told me I'm going to be working on a maths and physiology project now, I wouldn't have believed you 10 years ago. I was very much focused on working kind of in the laboratory rather than being a data scientist. My name's Manasi Nandi. I'm a cardiovascular pharmacologist at King's College London, and my research area is in sepsis and septic shock, and I'm working on a project to try and diagnose that earlier. So sepsis is a major clinical problem worldwide. It kills tens of thousands of people in the UK, more than breast and bowel cancer. It can affect anyone, and it's effectively a response to an infection that can result in a very rapid deterioration of the cardiovascular system. So diagnosing these patients earlier is absolutely critical. What I'm working on is collecting data from the clinic where blood pressure or ECGs have been captured from patients, and then we're trying to see if we can see patterns of how those waves change in a patient that goes on to recover versus a patient that goes on to decline and become seriously ill. There's a big push for interdisciplinary collaboration, and so there's a real interest in trying to partner up biologists with mathematicians or engineers or physicists so that we can apply different ways of thinking to solve complex problems. The mathematicians, they're developing the mathematical coding to help us analyse the signals in a meaningful way. So it's a really nice interdisciplinary project, and we've got to learn each other's languages and speak each other's languages. We use a method which takes the raw data and replots it in three dimensions. And by doing that and by applying another manipulation to the system, we are able to generate what we've called an attractor or a cardiomorph, which is effectively a new way of looking at the original signal. And every feature of that triangle relates to some feature on the shape of the waveform. The big question now is, can the attractor method be used to diagnose or detect sepsis earlier in patients? So in the preclinical data sets, it suggests that there are clear differences in the attractor between a healthy animal versus an animal in the early stages of sepsis. And what's interesting is if you just look at the conventional waveform, you wouldn't necessarily get that idea. So it seems to be very sensitive at detecting something that happens in those really, really early stages of sepsis. So if we can translate that clinically, that would, you know, increase the time window for a doctor to bring on board treatments, and that's the idea. So I'm really excited that this project is now at a stage where we're starting to look at human data, at clinical data, and potentially in the next 5 or 10 years, if it all works out, this could be something that would be implemented in clinical practice. So that's incredibly exciting potential of the project, and fingers crossed we get there. So this is a really interesting job. Research is, you're constantly inspired and you're constantly learning, and also one thing leads to another, so it may feel that you're doing something quite niche and you can't necessarily see the bigger picture or where it goes, but with research, before you know it, your project will end up branching off in different directions, and if you follow some of those, that can lead you to really interesting places.